Might be getting a bit colder at this time of year, but that doesn't mean you have to stop catching or lower your expectations. All it means is you've got to take a good look at your swim and think about where the fish might be hiding. Pick a swim with plenty of options and that'll give you more chance of catching fish. Now today we've come down to Wolves Farm in Northamptonshire on the Oaks Lake. Beautiful little lake, over 20 pegs, barbel, carp, bream. They feed all year round and you've always got a chance of a few bites here. But as with any fishery, the fish don't just spread around everywhere at this time of year. They're going to hole up in certain areas. It's all about picking a peg. It gives you lots of areas to explore and more chance to find them. Now, the swim that I'm sat on today, I think, looking at it, gives me 5, 6, 7 options. If one doesn't work, it's not the end of the world. I can always look at somewhere else. So, the first place I looked at when I turned up today was the island. Always a good holding area at this time of year. Could be undercut, snags hanging off it. Always got a good chance of holding some fish. Second of all, got the lily pads dotted around here. Again, it's all about cover. If it's cold, it's going to make that water that 1 degree different maybe in terms of that little bit warmer. Might sound like nothing, but trust me, at this time of year, those fine margins make all the difference. Third place I look at, just the open water. Doesn't have the cover, but it's unlikely to have more depth. Wouldn't be my first choice to look, but could there be fish there? Yes, definitely. Especially silverfish, maybe like bream, roach, even barbel, which this lake's got up to, I've just been speaking to the owner, up to 9 pound. Fourth place, on the far bank. Now there's pegs over there, but if there's no anglers over there, the fish will sometimes push away from the away from where people are congregated. It is chucking to a margin. If you try down your near margin, you might not catch. But if you go to the far margin, it's as far away as from the people can be, that's where they may go. Fifth, down in the little gully to my left here between the island and between the margin. Now that's probably on this little method feeder, well, hybrid feeder I'm chucking today, that's probably 20 metres. Again, it's just somewhere that people can't get into. It gives you that little bit of space, and that gives the fish the little bit of space just to back away and get away from any commotion. And that's where the feeder's in at the moment. And I've actually just had a couple of carp down there, so there's certainly some fish holding up. And the last one, it's a bit of a throwaway, it might work 2 or 3 times out of 10, is the margins. And even normally on the feeder today, there's no reason why you can't just underarm it. So if you pick a swim like this, rotate your areas, find out where the fish are sitting, and there's no reason that this winter has to be bleak. So I've been searching my peg all day. As I said earlier, I've had a few down to the channel to my left. And earlier, I've accidentally, as you do, dropped a few micro pellets in the edge. And I've seen a few swirls there, right in front of me, the mud churned up. Didn't think I'd catch them there. So just gone 5 or 6 metres down to my left. Just put a handful of micros on, drop the feeder on. A few indications, so fingers crossed that's going to go round. Let's see what happens. Ain't been warm today. When that could be your result, it's well worth getting out. It hasn't come easy. It's all about searching the peg, find the fish, and you'll get the bites, and you'll forget how cold it is in an instant. Give it a go. Don't hibernate this winter.